May ngagas tanan, imayaw ng Ginoo nga makaupod ko kamo subong nga aga sa aton online devotion. Sa aton pagsugod, pangabay kong tanan sa pag-open sa inyong Bible in Luke chapter 2. Magabasa kita verse 8 to verse 9, then magalumpat kita from verse 15 to verse 18. Magabasahon ko ini sa King James Version. Luke chapter 2, 8 and 9. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. In verse 15 to verse 18, and it came to pass, since the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see these things which is came to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherd. As we continue, let us pray. Our gracious God, Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful morning that you have given us the privilege, Ginoong, makatuon sa iyong pulong. Biligi kami, Ginoo, sa paghangop, kaga pag-apply sa amon matunan, kagabay, Ginoo, sa amon pag-tuon sini, kaga pag-apply sini, Ginoo, kabay nga ito ang amon mahimaya. Salamat, Ginoo, kagsaliwat, ibalik namon sa iyong pagdayaw. In your name, pray. Amen. So, I entitled this sermon this morning, How the Shepherds Celebrated Their First Christmas. Do you still remember your first Christmas? Of course, bata pa lang kita, no? And na-experience na ito ng first nato niya mga Christmas. Pero kung tanong natin bala, as we look at the world today, ang ilang celebrations ng Christmas is about family, food, parties, activities, Christmas carolings, mga trees, damo, Santa, no? Damo sa mga butang, ang ginabutang natin, dira, no? Nag-center kita, kisasa mo ng mga bubutang, kakalipatan naton kung sin o gibala. Kahit ano gibala ang Christmas. What is it all about? Actually, kung tanong nga itong bala, mag-look back kita in the history. Especially when we look at the Bible, mag-atanaw kita sa Bible, makita naton sa apang nga gintunan, sa Luke, makita naton nga it didn't started that way. The first Christmas started with a couple. Akondiin ang wife nagabusog kaga nagapangita sila sang balay nga mapuy-an kay tungod magabata nang iya nga ang babae ang wife sang amo nga lalaki kag wala sila sa makitaan sang place, so they have to stay in a manger, a lowly manger, para lang ibata ang ilang baby, no? Kaga, if you look back, pagin, makita naton, balaan sang amuning nga couple, this person, this baby inside of this woman is not just an ordinary person. And I do believe, Joseph, nangita niya sang lugar, no? Ang amuning nga, ang husband, nangita niya sang lugar para mapuyan sang amuning nga baby because he knows that this baby deserve a place, a wonderful place to be born. Yet, makita natin. Because no one knows this baby, they didn't find any place to stay. So in verse 7, makita natin, no? Verse 6 and verse 7, and so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger because there was no room for them in the inn. That is Luke chapter 2 from verse 6 to verse 7. So wala sila choice. And while this is happening, makita natin verse 8, shepherds, ara sila sa field. They are guarding their sheep. And more probably, they are looking at the sky, the stars, not expecting that this is a wonderful, wonderful night. Why? Because tonight is the first Christmas. And they are the first people that were invited to attend the first Christmas. But it didn't happen that way at first. Why? Because makita natin that while they were there, in verse 9, and lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. So, the first celebration na ilagin celebrate ang Christmas, ang first thing na natapo is that they celebrated with fear and wonder. Why? Because they found themselves in the presence of an angel. And they were so afraid because again, ara ka sa kadulom sa panasan lugar, tapos ba't dito walang makita mo, tapos biglang may anghel nagpakita sa mo, ano balang balat syagun mo, more probably mahadlukan kagid. What is this? Why are you here? Diyan na, grabe mo guru kadlong, no? Makibot ka, no? Hadlo ka ba? Si bala, anong kano sa mamuni ng anghel? Ba, si patso na kami? Or whatever, no? Pero makita natin, the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day this, in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. So, amuna ang Luke chapter 2, verse 10 to 12, no? Makita natin, nga, hindi kambas ang angel, don't be afraid. Because hindi ni dapat time para magkadlok. Instead, this is a time of great celebration. Because this day is the time for good tidings and great joy. Because the Savior was born. So, again, they started with fear and wonder, then it turned out into a celebration. Why? Why is there a celebration? It's because there is someone who was born this day, and that is the Savior. And kung tanong natin dire, makita natin na in verse 12, and this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. So if you look at this verse, makita natin that this is an invitation. I'm not just informing, the angels is not informing, just informing the shepherd, nga ginbata ang Savior, kundi kina-inform niya, kung diin, kung paano. Wow! Kung ikaw di ang shepherd, ano pala tiyagon mo? To be invited to see this wonderful moment, to be the first visitor of the Savior. The first invited guest of the Savior. Wow! Sinugid ba na? Kung ikaw sa lagay sang shepherd, grabe yung guro nga pala tiyagun. Grabe guro yung mukalipay. Kay tungod sa kadakbudamo sang tao sa palibot nila, God, the angels could have invited kings. He could have invited a priest, people with position. Yet he picked, or God picked, lowly shepherds. God's Ginoo. If you look at it, grabe ang opportunity nga ini. Ginhatag sang Ginoo sa mga shepherd. An opportunity to meet the Lord. And if I look at it, sometimes, as I look at this verse, makita ko man ang akong self. Because I have met the Lord as well. I met Him along the way. As I live my life, nagpakilalang Ginoo sa akin, kag na-realize ko how sinful I am, and I accept Him as my personal Savior. He gave me an invitation to know Him, and through His grace, we are now in a relationship. And I do believe most of us hearing this have that wonderful moment, man, sa inyong kabuhi. E gintawag ka mo sa Ginoo, gintawag ka mo. Kag ka mo namati. I-invite ka mo. Kag ka mo nagbaton. Kag subong. Ang amuning a Christmas is not a moment of fear of or just simply wonder, but a moment of wonderful celebration. Because this is the commemoration of Christ's birth. We Christians should celebrate Christmas with great joy. Why? Because sino pa bala ang magkalipay sa ang pag-abot sang Ginoo kundi kita nga nakabaton sang dako nga regalo, sang kaluwasan paagi sa iya. Because Jesus Christ didn't just came here, no? But He died for us. Muna makita man natin sa Matthew, no? He came to pay for our sin. What an amazing turn of event, no? Sa balatsyagon sa shepherd, uy, abig ko gani, i-judge na ko. Ay, abig ko gani, mihinmuhon sa ako ng angel. Now, He is inviting me to celebrate. To be with this couple and their baby. And this baby is not just a simple baby. This is not just a simple king. This is not just a simple person. This is my Savior. This is our Savior. And if you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior today, celebrating Christmas will be amazing to you. But until then, Christmas will be just an occasion. So, I urge you, and I do believe the Lord Himself is inviting you. Kung ari ka din subong, hindi mo pakilala si Jesus Christ, He is inviting you to get to know Him. Just like the shepherd, come! Meet the Lord. Meet me. Know me. So that you will know how much I love you. That is what I experienced. The second, they didn't just celebrate it with fear and wonder, but they also celebrated it with prioritizing the Lord. They celebrate this occasion by prioritizing the Lord. Kung nalang natin verse 15, makita natin, hambal dire, and it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see these things which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. So makita natin that when they talk about this, makita natin it was an invitation. Gintawag kami, may opportunity kami to meet the Savior. So kung ikaw may amo na bala, gintawag ka sa pinari, may padalang kami sang letter, be, no? Sang hari, or maybe the president will send you a letter and say mo, please come and visit me. Anong imo respond? More probably, you will leave everything and go. And more probably, nangita ka sa pinakanaming abayo, kag magkanto dito, kag magpagkita sa amuning person. Kag makita naton, ang amuning mga shepherd, they talk with each other and they, what? They forget everything. Again, tandaan naton that they are taking care of their sheep. I don't know what did happen. Ano ginhimo nila sila sheep? But we could know that they know that Jesus Christ should be prioritized more than anything. And that's why they move with haste. But sa Ginoo, are we still prioritizing Jesus Christ no? Sa atong kabuhi. These shepherds, but ang nila nga, ang tanan, apart from the Savior, wala na siya as value. Kanggit sa amuning moment, sa amuning opportunity. And kita man, kung tanong natin la, may opportunity kita to glorify the Lord all throughout our life. And sometimes, kakalipatan natin kung anong dapat natin i-prioritize. And even as we celebrate Christmas, kisa, kakalipatan natin that this Christmas should not be centered to anything else but the Lord. It should only be the Lord. Ginoo lang ang reason nga aga celebrate kita sa Christmas. And that's the reason why we should prioritize Him every time we celebrate Christmas. Kay wala na sang iban pa dapat naton i-center ang Christmas. Kundi siya lang. Because iya ni birthday. Iya ni siyang aton celebrator. And that's the reason nga, kita dapat, samtang ga-celebrate kita Christmas, siya dapat ang center sa tanan. Siya ang imo priority. Diba? Pag Christmas, pag birthday gani, kung panundo mo naton ang tanan, nga, tanan, siya ang nagakapot, siya nagablow sang cake, siya ang nag-open sang gifts, siya ang tanan. Tanan nga, beauty, ara siya, kisa, gina-makeupan pa, ginapanami pa nga man, because siya ang pinaka-center sang amuni nga celebration. Kag amo manitani, sa Ginoo, siya dapat ang sentro sang atong celebration. Wala na sang iban, wala na, hindi ikaw, hindi ako, hindi ang atong family, hindi ang kung ano man na, kundi ang manugluwas ng gid, and that is Jesus Christ. Siya ang priority sang atong Christmas. The third is not that these people celebrated it, the Christmas, their first Christmas, in fear and wonder. They didn't just celebrate it with prioritizing the Lord, but also they celebrated it with preaching and speaking about the Savior, sharing what they have heard and seen. Kuto na tong bala. In verse 17, hambal diri, when they saw this, nakita nila ang babe, si Joseph, si Mary, lying the baby lying in the manger. In verse 7, and when they had seen it, they made known abroad and say the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherd. So, ma-notice nato in verse 17 nga after na makita ini, gin-share nila ang ilang nakita, kag ilang nabatian, ang ilang experience sa tanan nga nakilala nila. Abroad, all throughout the land, they have preached and they have shared what they have experienced. Tama man sa atong tani, no? Tani, ang kung ano man ang naagong naton kay Jesus Christ, dapat amo man yung gina-share naton. Just like the shepherd, no, ginubra nila, gin-share nila ang gospel, gin-share nila ang kamaturan that Jesus Christ was born. Gin-bata na siya, kag may katsansa na kita maluwas. No? Kay ara na, manugluwas, ara na, praise the Lord. Give Him glory and honor because He is born. Kaya amo ni makita naton sa ila respond, they were so joyful. Hindi nag-stop ang ila baba sa pag-speak about the wonderful experience that they have experienced that night. Kabutod sa Ginoo, dapat amo man kita na. I do believe tanan kita nga nakabati, kag nakabaton kay Jesus Christ bilang iya personal luwas. Dapat may same man attitude kanggit sa kamo ni mga shepherd. They will desire to share everything they have heard, seen, and experienced to others so that others will also be joyful and knowledgeable about this Savior. But so, you know, if there is something that you could offer the Lord this Christmas, it is this. Preach about Him. Teach about Him. share Him to everyone that you know, so that they might also hear and experience the Lord. So this Christmas will not just be an occasion for them, but a wonderful celebration. Why? Because when Jesus Christ came, salvation is available. And because they have already accepted Jesus Christ, they also are the recipient of that wonderful salvation. Kag may purpose git, may meaning git sa ila, kag sa aton man, ang amuni nga celebration. So kabay pa kaw sa Ginoo. We learn from the shepherd and celebrate Christmas the right way. And put Christ in the center of our Christmas. Let us pray. Our gracious God, Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful day that you have given us the privilege, Ginoo, nga makatuon kag makapamati sa imong pulong. Ikaw mag-bless kag mag-guide, gamitang imong pulong, Ginoo, mag-remind sa amon why and how we should celebrate our Christmas. Kabay, Ginoo, ang kabuhi sa nga muna yung mga shepherd will be a model nga amon man himungon, Ginoo, upon receiving you as our personal Savior, upon knowing you as our personal Savior. Thank you, Ginoo. Nagsalibat, pinabalik naman sa iyong pagdayaw. And sa iyong pray, Amen.